eh, kumisa na etos dito sa mga forum na ganito, eh nasasabi, oh, yung Marcoses are accused of revisionism. Revisionism, pinapalitan lang namin ang kwento ng kasaysayan. Who is doing the revisionism? Linagay nila sa libro ng textbook ng mga bata na ganito, na ang mga Marcos, ganitong ninakaw, ganito ang ginawa. Ngayon, lumalabas sa korte, hindi totoo lahat ng sinabi ninyo. Dahil hindi nyo naipakita. I can call anyone a murderer. I can call anyone a thief. But I have to prove it. Kung hindi, eh, salita lang yan. That's just hot air coming out of my mouth. And it turns out, even in their case, it was only propaganda. And meaning, they maintain, pinilit na patagalin para masabi lang, ah, hindi, masasamang tao yan. Tingnan mo, ang dami nilang kaso. The fact na marami kang kaso, eh, siguro para sa atin, sasabihin, yun ang kanilang intent. Pero lumabas na talagang walang ebidensya. In other words, yung kanilang sinasabi na ninanakaw namin, na ginawa namin, na ganito, hindi lahat totoo. Paano kung nasasabi yun, yan ang desisyon ng korte. At there was no evidence. And that was always been our contention. And the reason na tumagal na ganito ay propaganda, pampolitika. Para masabi, ah, hindi, magnanakaw yung mga yan. Tingnan mo, marami silang kaso. Well, sa ngayon, wala na kaming kaso. Wala na yung kaso na sinasabi ninyo. That was the major case of 002. So that was that decision has put pain to all of these assertions that they have been making, not only in the public forum, but even in the teaching of our children of things that did not happen and claiming that they are history. Now, I think that is the very definition of revisionism. And that is one of the very important what the kids call takeaway from the decisions of the court is that we always knew that these were true. Pero yun na nga, nagagamit yung salitang revisionism, sino ang nagre-revise ng kasaysayan? Wala kaming sinasabi na hindi totoo.
Would you also call now for the revision ng ating mga textbook?
Of course, we have been calling for that for years. Pero siyempre, ang nakaupo, under the influence of our opposition. So, pero hindi tama, hindi rin naman tama yun. Kasi what has been proven wrong is essentially what they continue to contend in the textbooks of our children is essentially you are teaching the children lies. Tinuturoan ninyo ng kasinungalingan.
So you're reiterating your earlier call na dapat i-revise itong ating mga textbook?
Oh, talaga naman. Eh, tsaka huwag natin ibibigay sa mga political appointee.
Yes.
Kung ibigay niyo sa mga professor ng history professor, mga political scientists, sila magsulat niyan para magandang pagkaturo. What we are trying to teach is understanding and an involvement in politics in our young people that may bahagi sa kanilang buhay yan. Dapat sila ay nakikilahok, dapat sila ay nagpapakita ng interest dyan. Imbis na nangyayari ngayon na sinasabi, ginagamit lamang pampolitika. Tinuturuan natin sila to hate people. We are teaching that this group, kahawala, galit tayo dyan, masapsamang tao. Yan ang tinuturo nila. Hindi naman siguro tama.